For the first time, astronomers have detected a ring of dust circling around another planet in an entirely different solar system 2 quadrillion miles away. The planet Saturn in our own solar system is well known for its brilliant system of rings. These rings are made up of billions of chunks of ice, rock, and dust. Although they are nowhere near as big or bright, the other gas giant planets in the solar system, Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune, are also encircled by their own systems of dusty rings. But Saturn's rings are very different from the recently discovered ring around the planet PDS 70C. This new discovery could offer some clues as to what happened during the very early history of our solar system. The solar system we live in is very old. The Sun, the planets, moons, and asteroids have been here for billions of years, 4.5 billion years to be precise, and will be here for billions of years more and aren't expected to change all that much. The story is very different for PDS 70, a star 370 light years away in the constellation Centaurus. This star is very young, so young in fact that it isn't even a proper star yet. PDS 70 is a part of a class of stars known as T Tauri stars. Stars like our own Sun are called main sequence stars. Our Sun's core is so incredibly hot and dense that it is able to compress hydrogen atoms together to create helium atoms, in a process called nuclear fusion. Every time hydrogen is fused together into helium, some energy is released. This highly efficient fusion furnace in the Sun's core is what has kept it burning bright for billions of years. But a T Tauri star is still in the infant stages of its evolution. It is not able to produce nuclear fusion in its core, not yet. Every star begins the same way, as a cloud of gas and dust in space known as a nebula. Eventually, gravity begins to pull that cloud together, compressing the gas into a tight sphere. As compression continues, it grows hotter and hotter until it grows bright, almost like a star. This is a fledgling T Tauri star. They are hot and bright, but the core is not yet hot enough nor dense enough to crush hydrogen atoms together. Before fusion begins, T Tauri stars are also very unstable, known to vary in brightness quickly and chaotically, periodically giving off sudden bursts of powerful solar wind. PDS 70 is still in this violent formational phase. It is only an estimated 5.4 million years old. That may sound like a very long time by human standards, but it is practically the blink of an eye in astronomical terms. PDS 70 has only been around for 0.1% of the time that the Earth has. By the time PDS 70 formed, the dinosaurs had already been dead for 60 million years, and the first early ancestors of humans had begun to evolve. PDS 70 is so young that it is still in the process of forming its planetary companions. After a T Tauri star collapses down from its stellar nursery, some of the leftover gas and dust will collect into a wide flat ring known as a circumstellar disk. The disk is the source of material for new planet formation. Gravity will gather the gas and dust together into small clumps which will grow and grow, gathering more material like a snowball rolling down a hill. Over the course of several million years, those clumps, or planetesimals, will eventually grow to the size of entire planets. A circumstellar disk has been observed in orbit around PDS 70 since 2006. The disk is around 140 times wider than the Earth's orbit around the Sun. Astronomers have also observed some strange gaps in PDS 70's circumstellar disk. In 2018, they found the culprit. The dust in that gap had been swept up to form a Jupiter-sized planet, PDS 70b. The next year, an even larger planet, PDS 70c, was also detected. PDS 70c is around 4.5 times more massive than Jupiter and circles its small orange sun in a wide 190-year orbit. But more exciting than the discovery of two new planets is what Dr. Myriam Benisty's team at the Atacama Large Millimeter Array, or ALMA, has discovered in the space around planet PDS 70c, its own miniature ring of dust. This is exciting for two reasons. One, it means that the planet is still growing. It is adding more mass to itself little by little every day, as its gravity sucks in more of the surrounding gas and dust. And two, this dusty ring is evidence of the ongoing formation of moons. The gas giant in our solar system, like Jupiter and Saturn, are the parents to a few dozen moons each. Jupiter alone has 79 known moons, the largest of which is even larger than the planet Mercury. How does a planet collect so many companions? Gravity is certainly a factor. Jupiter is the largest planet in the solar system, and with a mass 300 times that of Earth, has a very strong gravitational pull, strong enough to hold on to plenty of moons. But there must be another factor at play as well. Looking at the orbits of Jupiter's largest moons, they all lie in the same plane, precisely aligned with Jupiter's equator. The most logical explanation is that all these moons form there. The prevailing theory has been that, during Jupiter's formation from the circumstellar disk, a similar circumplanetary disk formed around the planet. It was out of this circumplanetary disk that Jupiter's moons were created. For the very first time, we have concrete evidence to support this theory. The PDS-70 system has been described by Dr. Sebastian Haffert of the University of Arizona as the textbook example of planet formation. Dr. James Wang of Caltech said, "We know so little about satellite formation. PDS-70C is certainly a stepping stone in understanding when and how efficiently satellites form around planets. So, since the planet Saturn is surrounded by a ring of dust, does that mean it is going to form a new moon?" The short answer is, probably not. In fact, it's probably the opposite. Saturn has not had its famous rings for very long, probably only the past 100 million years. The debris that forms Saturn's rings still orbits too close to the planet for it to gather itself back together to form another moon. Instead, all of that debris is slowly falling down onto the planet. In the next few hundred million years, Saturn's rings may become a thing of the past. Unfortunately, this means that there is no suitable analog for a circumplanetary disk to study in our own solar system. Because of that, and because the PDS-70 planetary system is so distant, much of it remains clouded in mystery. There are still a lot of unanswered questions about PDS-70C's circumplanetary disk. Astronomers aren't quite sure what the disk is made of, how big it is, or even how massive. Dr. Benisty's team has made some rough estimates to try to get a better idea of what is happening inside the system. They guess that the disk might be as wide as Earth's orbit and contain about 3 times the mass of Earth's moon. Their estimated mass, if it's correct, is actually surprisingly small, especially compared to the mass of the planet itself. Such a small circumplanetary disk-to-planet mass ratio would indicate that the planet has already used up most of the material. It is nearing the end of the formation process. While PDS-70C is probably still growing, it is very slow, and it probably won't grow much larger than it already is. The same goes for whatever moons might be growing within the dusty circumplanetary ring. The hidden moons are most likely close to being fully formed. In a few million more years, the dust will all have been collected by these moons or have fallen down onto the planet itself. Given planet PDS-70C's massive size, the moons could be the size of some planets in our solar system, potentially even larger than the planet Mars. Unlike its companion, PDS-70B does not show any evidence of a circumplanetary disk. This could simply indicate that it has finished building all its moons. Since planet C is farther from the star than planet B, it might capture most of the infalling dust from the outer regions of the solar system, only leaving a small stream of dust to pass through for planet B to use. Whatever the case may be, if there are any moons in orbit around the planets of system PDS-70, it will be impossible to detect them with our current technology. It will likely be several more years before the first announcement of the discovery of an exomoon. Still, the discovery of this circumplanetary disk is a landmark achievement in the history of exoplanetary science. Studying the PDS-70 system is akin to looking back at a time when our own solar system was still in its infancy. By learning more about this distant, newborn planetary system, we might be able to fill in some unanswered questions and create a more complete picture of how planetary systems across the cosmos come to be.